There's some big heart health news out today.
The results of a landmark study could mean the guidelines for healthy blood pressure are actually about to change. Now, when you get your blood pressure taken, they give you two numbers. But what do those numbers actually mean? Good question. Amelia just had hers done, Heather. She's
wondering.
But this is so interesting. So this survey was such a big deal that they actually stopped the testing and said we need to publish our results immediately.
They stopped it 2 years early. That's how significant the results were, because they found that in people older than 50 with high blood pressure, when you brought that top number down from 140 to 120, they had a 27% lower risk of dying from a heart problem. How's your blood pressure?
High.
Mine is very fine.
I haven't been to the doctor in a while.
Ah, so you don't even know your blood.
I don't.
Right now, 120 over 80 is considered normal. 140 over 90 is considered high.
High blood pressure, the heart is squeezing against this pressure. The higher the blood pressure, the harder the heart has to squeeze or to work.
Dr. Kamara March is a cardiologist with University of Minnesota Heart.
So it's kind of like a hose. If you kind of put a kink in a hose, the pressure on the other side is higher, so you can see that hose is building up pressure to get the blood or the water through.
What do those numbers mean?
It really doesn't mean very much. He tells me it's high, and so I believe him.
Okay.
So he's a good doctor.
The top number is the pressure when the heart beats.
The pressure that your heart is pumping against as it's putting the blood outside of the heart.
The bottom is the pressure between beats.
The relaxation number, so the pressure that's left after the heart's pumped out.
They get the reading by watching the meter and listening to your blood come through.
And yours is very low.
I usually have a low blood pressure.
Can you have a blood pressure that's too low?
Yes, and that's why we haven't been as aggressive, because of that other range.
In some cases, below 120 can lead to fainting and dizziness.
Are you more concerned about the top number or the bottom number?
We're concerned about both of them.
So you're a nurse. Do people really get white coat hypertension?
Oh, yeah.
They see a doctor in a white coat and it makes them nervous.
So then they let me sit in the room for 10 minutes and it comes down.
Okay. So yes, nerves, stress, even talking when your blood pressure is being taken, it can raise it 20, 30 points. So they have to look at the average there. Now, Dr. March says more studies will probably need to be done before she sees any major changes to those recommendations. But she also said that if you are in that 120 to 140 range, doctors might look at you more closely now as an individual. Like, do you have diabetes? Do you have sleep apnea? And may adjust some of those things.
Well, it sounds like they should, based on what they found. Mm-hmm.
Right. But that study was just for people 50 and older. So they have to look at some people without the high blood pressure in that area. And so we'll see what happens. But it's a huge study. And to stop it 2 years early, with such a drop in the mortality, is a big deal.
Yeah, we should take note for sure.
All right. Yep. Thank you, Heather.
If you have a good question, you can email it by going to WCCO.com/links.